I think for me, every single time I've stepped on the ice, especially growing up, actually even more so in college, just stepping on the ice has always allowed me to free my mind of the other responsibilities I have going on in my life, whether it's school or friends or family or whatever. I'm just skating, I'm doing what I love, and that's how it's always been for me.
I think when I was younger, I didn't really know why I enjoyed it. I just thought it was fun. Since I've come such a long ways with skating, I think that it's just become such a big part of my life, and I can't imagine, like, all the lessons I've learned from skating, as cheesy as that sounds, like, all the friends I've made are some of the closest friends I've ever had.
I enjoy skating because it's this really interesting blend of, like, artistic elements and also technical elements. Once you start practicing and becoming better at skating, it's really fun to, like, jump and spin and do a program. Of course, I really love the community I've, like, found throughout, like, my time as a competitive figure skater. So I basically grew up competing against the same people for 12 years. The skating, I've always, like, said, is, like, my second home. It's, like, my second family. I know, personally, I really like learning new tricks, I guess, jumps. Skating is such a detail-oriented sport. Like, with jumps, if you are off even by a little bit, you're gonna fall. So I really like how, I guess, challenging that is, and, like, being able to do these jumps and, like, test myself to see what I can do, like, in a given situation. And I also really love the performance aspect of it. Even in competitions, like, your program, which will be, like, either, like, 3 or 4 minutes, it has, like, a lot of musical aspects, and it's just so much fun to, like, perform and just skate out there on your own. And dance kind of, like, is a supplement to skating as well. You have, like, all these, like, technical challenges for yourself, but you can also go out there and perform and just basically forget about everything else except that moment.
So I'm in Body Hype dance company here at Princeton, and the benefit has been mutual. Like, my figure skating has definitely helped my dance, because you learn to move relatively smoothly, you learn to control your body in figure skating, but also, obviously, dance helps your movements become more clean on ice.
Since my sophomore year, I've been the president, so it's been about a year and a half now. I've been a president of the figure skating club.
Step, cross, tuck, step, step, mohawk, lean. All right, let's do from the beginning up through the line, and just do the best you can. This is, like, a ton of choreography we threw at you today.
I'd say more people know than they did, but a lot of people still don't realize that there's, you know, a skating program here, probably because we're a club sport. You know, Princeton doesn't recruit for figure skating or anything like that.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And a lot of people, you know, didn't even know what synchro was, like, what kind of, it's not an Olympic sport yet, it should be, hopefully soon. I think recently, as our show especially has gotten bigger, more people are aware that there's a team.
So synchronized skating, the way I always describe it to people, is basically you just have 16 girls or guys on the ice at once, and we all do things in sync. So it's not so much focused on the freestyle with, like, jumps and spins. It's more focused on all skating together, which looks really cool.
All the skaters are doing, like, a structured move, like a circle or a block or a line, where it's, like, visually you see the shapes that they're making on the ice. And the steps are all, you know, choreographed to be the same or different in a structured way.
It's mesmerizing when it works and everyone's together. It's kind of cool to like not put that much effort in and get places really fast. But more importantly, I think the people are just amazing as well. As soon as you meet someone that does synchro, like you automatically have bond. Like you don't even need to say anything more. Like you already have something to talk about that a lot of other people just don't share. It's like an instant connection and people you can always depend on seeing and people that you know you can trust because you have to trust them. For example, you might have to connect to someone and you just have to trust that they'll be there, or you might be getting flipped in the air and you have to trust that people won't drop you, or trust that they even come to practice. Stuff like that, you depend on them and it's great to have like that connection with people.
Like a lot of people underestimate us, but first of all, your endurance really had to be there because these programs, like 3 minutes might not sound like much, or 3.5 minutes might not sound like much, but like when you're skating on the ice and you have to give it your all for 3.5 minutes and you're doing these like crazy moves and you have to be in sync with everyone, it's really tiring. Especially for synchro, because you're always holding on to one another, you have to really have strong like arm, like upper body and like core muscles. I joined my first synchronized skating team when I was 8 years old, and I've been doing it ever since. This photo collage is what my teammates got me when I was a graduating senior. By the time I was in high school, when I was skating for Team USA, we had practiced probably about 10 hours a week total. And that's, I guess, why it kind of looks so like effortless and everything moves so well together by the time you like see them at nationals. I guess like when you get older, there's definitely more kind of that like kind of pressure on you. When you're younger, I would say like the atmosphere competitions is more like honestly really fun, because like it's just like suddenly you go there and you're like, wow, so many skaters. I had no idea these many people skated, and like they're like kind of all your age and everyone's super excited like to be all dressed up in their team gear and you kind of walk around looking like a cult. But I think like synchro also really does foster kind of being like a good sport. They teach you from a young age, you have to be respectful to your competitors and cheer for the other teams, say good luck to them, great skate, no matter what the results end up being. Team, like, being a good sport is most important.
So I would say at practices, when I was skating competitively, there's definitely like, I guess, a community vibe like within our rink. Like other students of my coach, like we would all support each other. But it was also like a very intense environment and each person was sort of doing their own thing and like focusing on their own goals. But we were still like, you know, helpful and supportive for each other. And I'd say at competitions, definitely the atmosphere was a lot more intense. Like, you're kind of like scoping out the competition and there's a lot of like, I don't know, just like typical like girl stuff, at least, you know, in the singles competition. So it can feel very intense, but there are also like really nice skaters out there that you meet, so.
So when I skated in my old club, we had to do synchro for a few years when we were novice skaters because our club had a novice synchro team. So I did it for, I think, 2 years. Yeah. It was very different because a lot of the things that you have to do well in single skating is basically the things you shouldn't be doing well in synchro. So the thing is, single skating very much gives you a survivorship mindset, in my opinion, in the sense that it's like no one else, you very much go into competition thinking no one else matters, what anyone else does not impact me at all, I am doing my thing, I am gonna go all out for me, no one else. And that's beneficial because it helps you ignore all the pressure from the audience and the judges, but also maybe hard to let go of in your normal life. when like a big competition's coming up and you start to think in terms of figure skating, you start to live it, you basically spend so much time skating, running programs, that you kind of let go of your non-figure skating life. And a lot of training camps during the summer, when you don't have the pressure of competitions, you could do fun things like try out new jumps with friends. You could have like jumping competitions. It would always be fun to like push each other and so on. And I think that social interaction is something I'd like to have more of in single skating.
Single skating was always a lot of pressure on me, and like literally just me, because it was an individual sport. And I also felt very lonely at times, because it's just you get on the ice every day, you train with your coach half the time, the other time you're practicing on your own. Whereas synchro, you're around, like, at least growing up, like my team was always like 20 girls, so you're just surrounded with like 19 of your best friends, like 24/7.
I like how as a single skater, you have control over your own body, so you don't have to rely on anyone else besides yourself.
It's definitely, I felt more challenged in individual skating, which was something that I definitely liked, but at a place like Princeton, it's nicer to have something that, you know, is not as demanding of your time and energy.
And like, you have your coach and you have your parents, but in the end, it's really like up to you to push yourself and up to you to like trust yourself to do jumps or, you know, feel the music or compete out in the ice. And in my opinion, it's this really special like personal connection that you feel to see like what you can do and how good you can become.
You know, 2 years ago, trying to get people to do the ice show was like pulling teeth to have enough numbers. We had to beg people to do solos so that we could fill out the show. And then this year, I'm having to tell people, you're in too many numbers. Like, the show's going to be too long. I know a lot of people had figure skating, you know, was a part of their life before they came to Princeton. And maybe they, you know, right up till they left for Princeton were skating. But a lot of people, you know, skated when they were younger, took a break, and all of those varieties of like experience, skill level, everything, you know, you can join the skating club, and it's like a great, you know, family for people who are just united by like our passion to skate.
I'm pretty happy with the skating community I found here at Princeton. I did not know what to expect. Like, the skating community was much bigger and like much more accepting and fun than I thought it'd be.
I really like the people in the club. I really feel like I can hang out with the people in the club and talk to them and study with them.
With like the spring show coming up and like all the preparations we're doing for that, like I definitely think that I'm like getting closer with the club and like feeling the whole figure skating community a lot more.